put chat where the big timer is, and then put the big timer where the little timer is. But I didn't get to it yet. Why do you not like it? Alright, let's go. New game pro. Gamer time. I started late, so we should probably get going. Yes, I'm going to relocate chat in the future. Okay. I am having to hold shift to sprint. I don't remember if that's normal. I mean, it is normal, but I don't remember if, like, I was doing that before. I don't think so. I think that these binds are from after when I changed that, so I have to update those. Some other time, though. R3 remake. Charm. I don't play none of that fucking whack-ass original RE shit. I'm not a fan of original RE games, you know? Like, they're just not video games to me. Original RE games? Oh. Well, that's karma. Original RE games honestly feel more like RPGs than anything else to me, or like a visual novel. You don't do anything in those games, you know? You just walk around. Like, your keys are forward, back, left, right, inventory, shoot. That's it. That's all it is. And the shooting is not even like shooting. It's just like dumping resources. That's like every single boss fight in a classic RE game is you just stand on the other side of the room and dump resources and pray that you had enough resources to kill the thing that you're trying to kill. But I personally don't find that very fun. I think it's like super boring. You spend like 98% of the playthrough just walking around from place to place. You know? That's why I really like RE4. Because, like, you do stuff in this game, you know? Like, you run around, you're throwing grenades, you're kicking people, you're suplexing monks. You know? You're doing stuff. But classic RE, I feel like, I don't know. The only one I've played is classic RE3, but it definitely felt like nothing was happening most of the game. You know what I mean? Like, oh, I'm walking from point A to point B. Oh, look, this is a room with enemies. There are two types of rooms in a classic RE game. There are rooms where you run past everything and never do any combat, which is every room that isn't a boss fight room. And then when you arrive at boss fight rooms, you stand on the other side of the room and shoot at the boss until the boss slowly makes its way to your side of the room. Then you run to the other side and rinse and repeat. Like, I don't even, it's like when I'm playing Pokemon, it doesn't really feel like I'm playing Pokemon, you know? Like, it feels like I'm watching my character play Pokemon. It feels like I am sitting behind a screen and, like, doing inputs, and the game is just doing whatever it wants. You know what I mean? I'm not, like, in direct control of what's happening. I'm just like, yeah, fucking Japanese dog fighting, basically. Like, go for it. I don't really find that engaging. I like when I, like, actually have direct control over the character I'm playing as. It's way more fun that way. Feels like I'm actually playing the game. Doesn't feel like I'm playing XCOM or something, you know? You're like, well, go to the other side then, I guess. And then your little RTS characters walk to the other side. There's, like, too much of a disconnect, you know? It's not supposed to be an action game. It's supposed to be a survival item management puzzle game, not a high-action gameplay-based shooter. Yeah, that's why it's bad. Because those games aren't fun. That's what I'm saying. I agree with you. But have you ever stopped to consider that puzzles in classic RE games are, like, some of the easiest shit ever made? Like, have you ever actually played a puzzle game? Like, you ever played Portal? Bro, if you take a classic RE fan and put them in, like, Factorio or even, like, Portal 2, their head will probably explode. Like, that's an actual puzzle. Like, classic RE puzzles be like, there are three items. A square, a circle, and a triangle. You must collect the square, circle, and triangle and put them into square, circle, and triangle holes. Once you do, you can progress. I don't know if you caught my drift, but that's literally like the, you know, square, circle, triangle, peg holes that little kids play with. That's essentially the puzzle difficulty of classic RE games, like doctor's office, idle children's toys, puzzles. Yeah, thanks, Cosmic. The Master Nug, yep. New layout. It's true, you just save ammo for the bosses? That's what I'm saying, dude. Like, it... Honestly, Village felt a lot like that on Village of Shadows. Where it was like... Okay, well, I need all of my resources for the bosses, so I just am not going to fight anything else. And then you just run past everything else. And the game becomes entirely about, like, how much... you're able to run past, you know? Instead of, like, you know, I don't know. I guess that is resource management, but it's not fun, in my opinion. This is boring. It's supposed to make you, supposed to be scary and make you think. Shooter games are mindless action of the most repetitive gameplay of all time. Bro, that's just because you're not playing them right. If you can't aim or actually engage with the mechanics, then yeah, of course it's repetitive.
Duh.
Skill issue, to be honest. You're not a big fan of the RE series? Me either. I like three games. RE4, RE4 Remake, RE5, RE3 Remake. That's it. Everything else sucks. Fuck no, I'm not pushing the boxes. That shit looks awful. I mean, I'm sure it'll be cool, but you know, as a runner, it doesn't look very fun. Also, like, in what universe are classic RE games scary? I don't know, like... I don't really find video games scary, to be honest. Maybe I'm just super desensitized. But... in the 90s? Yeah, but like, even if you played it for the first time now, you definitely wouldn't be scary. Like, I don't know. The games feel like running around a lot and not doing anything, because you're supposed to manage the resources and backtrack to progress in the game. Okay, but like, it's not like managing the resources is hard. You just pick up everything that you see, and then, you know,
what are you selling?
Walk past the stuff.
What are you buying?
That's in the way. Did I play RE3 with save states? No. No, I didn't. There's no need. The game is so fucking easy. When it works. Half of the mechanics don't even work. Like, the dodge mechanic in that game literally just doesn't work. The dodge gives no iframes, and you can roll into a wall and just get hit anyways. It's really fun. But, yeah, I mean... it's simple. It's like, oh, I guess I need to go back to that other area because I have an item now, which means I just need to pass by this section with enemies in it like 4 times. So I just like hug the left wall and run and I never get hit, you know? I love shooter games. They just get really repetitive once you do get good at them. Overwatch and shooters like COD just get boring. Well, you're playing dog shit shooters like Overwatch and COD, so of course they get repetitive. What do you mean, my guy? If you were out here playing Doom Eternal and CSGO, then you wouldn't feel this way. You just have bad selection bias. Yeah, like, I don't think that video game, like, classic RE was really ever that scary. I just think that you played them when you were a kid. Like, bro. Devil May Cry scared the shit out of me when I was a little kid, but that's because I was like 5. Everything was scary. Like everything. Bro, going to the airport was scary. You know what I mean? Like... classic RE games can be scary at times. I can't defend the dodge mechanic and I'm not even gonna try. Yeah, I mean, I think it was just poorly executed, but the rest of the gameplay is like, okay. It's just like there's no depth at all to it. But I just found it really boring. I just felt like I was just walking around. And like I think you can make a game that has like a horror aesthetic or whatever that like actually has good gameplay. Like obviously we're playing one right now, or like Dead Space. It's a good example. See, how's it going? Doom Eternal is one of my favorite games. It just gets so boring at a certain point. Have you ever stopped to consider that maybe you just are bored of video games and it has nothing to do with the ones that you're playing? Maybe you're just an adult and video games are boring now. Because it do be like that sometimes. Now you have motherfuckers that are not real in planes. That's pretty scary. Yeah, true. We'll talk. Stubbed your towel. I'm sorry. Dude, my binds are like different now. It's confusing me. Any quick turn to the side like that? Turn the camera, press aim. I don't see RE4 and 5 to be horror. Those games couldn't scare a toddler. I mean, when I was a little kid, RE4 scared me. Body horror is scary and stuff, and there's some suspenseful moments. The audio design carries it super hard. I was never scared of RE5 though. But like, this is what I don't understand. Like, genuinely, I don't understand horror media. Like, there's a couple of fundamental presuppositions that I just don't agree with when it comes to horror. Like, here's the first one. How, like, is horror supposed to be scary? Like, my understanding of horror as a genre is that, like, the point of it and the appeal is that it gives you the physical response of fear. And that is what's fun. Like, people like going to horror movies because they like when something jump scares them, they all jump, you know, and it gives them some adrenaline, you know, and that turns into dopamine and that feels good, right? Like, and that's why people like scary stuff. They like that, like, the feeling of being scared. Like, that's... I was under the assumption, like, is that what horror is? Like, that's why people like horror? But the more I've seen of horror, the less that seems to be true. Like, horror is just, like, an aesthetic. It's, like, zombies and, like, weird body parts and... like doom and gloom, and like that's horror. Even if it's like Shaun of the Dead, where it's a comedy, like the movie is not supposed to make you feel scared at all in any capacity. It's literally supposed to be funny, but people love, like, horror people love that movie just because it's got zombies in it. You know what I mean? It has absolutely nothing to do with the, like, the feeling of being afraid, right? Like, I don't understand horror at all. Like, people are, like, really attached to horror and love that, like, love horror and always want to be consuming horror media, but like, rarely ever are they, like, chasing the feeling of actually being scared. Maybe that's just because, like, when you do get that feeling of being scared, you get desensitized over time because you get braver, right? Like, your brain, like, starts to recognize the patterns, like, oh, this is not real, this is a movie or whatever, you know, like, the suspense goes away. Or maybe it's just, like, so hard to create that sort of atmosphere that people have just, like, given up on wanting that feeling and just take anything even remotely close. I don't know. It's weird to me. But, like, I don't understand why this is like a important aesthetic. I think horror is cringe. Like personally, I don't like having that fear response. It makes me uncomfy. Like I would much rather be like stoked and see stuff explode, you know? But I like zombies and body horror and stuff. I think it's a cool aesthetic. But I'm like not at all engaged with the idea of like having the emotional response of fear, you know, like so for me, I don't really care about a horror aesthetic at all. Like it's cool, but I don't think it not even really necessarily benefits from it at all. Like, I like some of the aesthetic stuff, but I mean, like, the actual horror element of it makes no sense to me. Yeah, I've played Silent Hill. I thought it was more thought-provoking than scary, to be honest. But I don't know, like, but people will call, like, anything horror. People call Left 4 Dead horror, but, like, I don't really feel like Left 4 Dead is really like trying to scare you. If it does, it's like really rarely trying to do so. Or like RE4, for instance, like it's pretty rare that RE4 is like genuinely trying to scare you and build the suspense or whatever, you know. Fucking is Plants vs. Zombies horror, you know? Like I don't know, doesn't make any sense. To your point, but that's not really horror. I freaking love Shaun of the Dead. It's funny. Wait, zombies are funny, but the horror movie. One second. The horror movies now are not scary because they're trying to be hard and edgy. Trying too hard to be edgy, but they should bring. To be trying to disturb you or make you feel uncomfortable. It doesn't have to be body horror or jump scares, going of the unknown, and blah, blah, blah. Yeah, but like, nothing does that though. Like, horror is such a big genre, like, huge part of every medium, but, like, the percentage of things that are actually trying to make you feel uncomfortable or do any of that is, like, next to zero. Like, name one game that actually tries to do that and is good at it. Like, maybe Silent Hill? I don't know. It's, like, really rare. And horror fans don't even necessarily care about those types of horror media more than any other type of horror media. Like, horror fans love Resident Evil, even though I would argue it's like barely even scary at all. But you don't see people like lining up to play some crazy shit, like some crazy horror game. I can't even think of one that's like legit like a crazy scary horror game, because they just don't exist. And like, also everyone like feels different things to be scary. Like when I played RE2 Remake, I fell asleep. I didn't get scared. Cause to me, I was just like, oh man, another hallway where there's gonna be enemies in it and I have no tools to deal with them. That doesn't make me scared, it just makes me bored. Makes me think, man, why is my character so useless? You know, for being the main character of this game, Leon is pretty dog shit in this game. That's how I felt. Playing 2 make, at least. Dude, what is this cabin? Yeah, I'm dead. See that, you know, maybe RE4 is horror. That was a terrifying cabin. Are you trying to kill me? Use this. Being useless in limited inventory is a trope of horror. Yeah, but it doesn't make me feel scared, it just makes me bored. Because I'm like, why would I be scared? This is a video game. You know what I mean? Like, I don't see a fucking zombie in RE2 Remake, and I'm like, oh man. Ah, a zombie. And I'm like, oh, that sucks. That's really annoying.
Are you trying to kill me?
I can't do anything about it because my character in this game sucks and can't do anything. I'm not, like, afraid of losing progress or whatever either. Like, oh, if I die, then I just have to do, like, this 2 minutes of walking again or whatever. And that's not like, oh, I'm afraid of doing this 2 minutes of walking again. It's like, oh, if I do this 2 minutes of walking again, that's two more minutes of doing nothing but walking. That's boring. You know what I mean? But maybe that's just because I don't care to engage with them that way at all. Because I just like, I'm here to play the video game, I'm here to interact with the mechanics and stuff, so if there aren't mechanics, like if I'm not finding it fun to play in the moment to moment, then I'm not going to be invested. You know what's actually scary? When I'm playing Left 4 Dead 2 and I'm playing like a fucking beast and there's like 600s around me. That's scary. Like I will get legit jump scared and like shit my pants if I'm playing like Left 4 Dead and I'm playing like, you know, like yesterday when we had like a million chargers chasing us. But it's not, I wasn't scared because there was like a lack of resources and there was nothing I could do to stop this like crazy enemy. I was scared because I had a ton of tools at my disposal and there was a ton of skill expression at play, but even with that it was like crazy insurmountable odds and stuff, and that's what makes it scary. What's the best horror game? Still fun, still scary? There isn't one. That's what I'm saying, dude. Like, in order to make the player feel like they're actually engaging and stuff and be fun in the moment to moment, you have to give them power, which will by definition not make it scary. Except for that, I don't know, maybe you can harness that example that I was just giving with Left 4 Dead. Like, to me it's kind of like a paradox. If you don't have control and you don't have any tools to stop like scenarios from happening, then it's not scary because like, it's not, well then it's not fun, right? Because you're not even engaging in the game. Like, you're just watching the game happen, basically. And, you know, if you have too many tools and you can just, like, skill expression your way through the game, then it's not scary because there's no stakes, because you just, you know, you play good, get better. I don't know, maybe something like roguelikes can be scary. You know, like when you're at the end of a run in a roguelike, that's terrifying, right? Because you're like actually are invested and don't want to lose your stuff and whatnot, but and it's only to a certain degree though, because when I'm playing Binding of Isaac and you know I'm like near the end of my run and I just get like some complete shit RNG, then it just becomes like, oh, I'm not invested anymore, like this run is already over, I just got unlucky, you know. Resident Evil 7 is terrifying as shit and still pretty fun. See, I totally disagree. Resident Evil 7 is literally like one of my least favorite video games of all time. It's so bad. Because there are like 3.5 hours... No, not really. But there's like 1.5 hours of cinematics and unskippable cutscenes in that game. And what do you do outside of these cinematics and unskippable cutscenes? Walk around. That's literally the whole game. There's like 5 enemies in that whole game. There are no systems in that game. All you do is walk around. There are like 8 enemies and 5 of them are boss fights. And almost all 5 of those boss fights are boring and like not fun. And I don't know, I didn't find it scary at all. I just was like, oh look, everything's wet. That's terrifying. I hate water. Oopsies. Choke me, daddy. I forgot that my QTE binds are changed. This is fine. But yeah, like, I don't know. I didn't find it scary. What's there to be afraid of? Everything just looks gross. You're gonna play RE4 Remake in VR? Nah. Imagine Bloom Aim in VR.
Are you okay, Leon?
You ever seen The Mist? It's a perfect movie example of what horror movies should be, but all the movies and games are trying to be scary instead of being... It's trying to be edgy instead of being scary. There's no perfect horror game because everyone is afraid of different things, so you need to find a good game or movie that's suited to your fears. If you look hard enough, you'll find it. But, like, being afraid is not an enjoyable emotion, so why would I do that? What would be the point of doing that? That sounds awful. What's that, Sportsies? What's my opinion on RE3 Remake? It's awesome. It's a great game. RE3 Remake is, like, way overhated. I made a whole video about it. But basically, like... Honestly... RE3... Original... is, like, mid at best. And... even the original fans... all said it was mid before RE2 Remake came out. And then when RE2 Remake came out, all of a sudden, RE3 was like the best original game and everyone loves it. But I remember before RE2 Remake came out, when I watched people who did RE3 OG speedruns, it was constantly referred to as like, yeah, it's okay. RE3 original, it's like mid, it's whatever, you know. But, you know, when RE2 Remake came out and everyone thought they were going to do an RE3 Remake, all of a sudden, RE3 Remake was like this amazing masterpiece of a game that everyone thought was their favorite.
Welcome.
And we're so excited for Capcom to remake it.
What are you selling?
When in actuality, everyone just thought the game was mid and just overhyped it super hard because the remake's coming. Boggers. So that sets the groundwork a little bit for the reception of it. But after RE2 Remake, people are like, oh, like, I really want like a faithful RE3 Remake, you know, like RE2 Remake was, even though RE2 Remake wasn't faithful whatsoever. Anyways, and Capcom was like, oh, RE3, like a not so popular classic Resident Evil game that's more focused on action than horror. We should lean into that on this remake and create something actually unique and like new instead of just rehashing what's already been done with 2 Make and the original. And so what they did is they made a game that has a high skill ceiling and a lot of replayability because the core mechanics are really enjoyable. And the audience for it did not want that. They wanted a one-to-one remake. But Capcom told them many, many times that, look, guys, this is not going to be a one-to-one remake. There's going to be more changes with this than 2 Make had. We're going to take more of a creative vision and try to create something unique. They said this in press conferences. They said it on Twitter all the time before the game actually came out.
Wait.
And then when the game did come out, and it's exactly what they said it was going to be, which is something that's not a one-to-one remake, then everyone lost their collective shit because the first playthrough is like 6 hours long. Wait. Which, by the way, is also the same length of the first playthrough of RE2 Remake, but, you know, don't tell anyone else that. Or your first playthrough of OG RE3, but don't tell anyone that. And then, you know, people collectively decided that adding substantially different difficulties in a game is not sufficient needs to replay the game. It's not actually extra content. So, like, they beat the game once on standard, and they're like, wow, okay, I have finished RE3 Remake. wow, this game only has 6 hours of content. When actually, there's Hardcore and Nightmare and Inferno, which all change the game in very drastic ways. Way more than the differences between RE2 Remix, Claire, and Leon scenarios, or its first and second scenarios. So you have RE2 Remake where one playthrough takes about 7 hours, but you have one playthrough that you do 4 times where they're all exactly the same. And then you have RE3 Remake where there's 3 very distinct different playthroughs that all take about the same amount of time. But, you know, you swap a character model and give like one new boss fight and all of a sudden it's a completely different game apparently. Even though 99% of the gameplay is exactly the same. First playthrough of OG RE3 takes way longer than Remake? Not true at all. My first playthrough of OG RE3 was like 8 hours long. That game is really short. But anyways, yeah, I mean, TLDR RE3 Remake, like, Capcom set out to make a game that had really good core mechanics and a lot of replayability based on difficulty modes, and the classic Resident Evil fans did not want that. They wanted a 1-to-1 remake of their beloved game that everyone thought was mid like 2 years before the game came out. And, yeah, so instead of, you know, taking the game for what it is and enjoying it for what it is and critiquing it for what it is, everyone's like, "Wah, this isn't what we wanted, wah," which, I mean, fair. If it's not what you wanted, fair, but, you know. I see a lot of people say that RE3 Remake is a bad game because it's not what they wanted, which is not how that works. That's like, imagine going to a fucking comedy movie. You go to like 50 First Dates or something and you're like, dude, this is a dog shit horror movie. I didn't get scared one time. I can't believe that they would make this horror movie so bad when you're literally like not watching a horror movie. And all the advertising for the movie was saying that it's a comedy. You know, like, they have signaled in any capacity that they possibly could that this is not a horror movie, and yet you were here watching a comedy, expecting it to be a horror movie. But yeah, I don't know, it's just dumb. And I get my main point in that video that I made about this is that, you know, that there is a bunch of replayability in the game and there is a lot of content to enjoy if you just play the extra difficulty modes. But people refuse to do that because people play video games nowadays, they play the game one time, if that, and then move on, consume more product. Which I don't understand because the same motherfuckers be playing Devil May Cry and they're like, "Oh yeah, dude, I love this. I'll play 7 difficulty modes. That's new content." Which I agree, 7 difficulty modes that all change the enemy arrangements everywhere is new content. But all of a sudden you do that in a Resident Evil game and that doesn't count as new content? Huh? Hello? Like what? Makes no fucking sense. This is insane. Like, would you really play Devil May Cry one time and be like, man, this game has no content? It only took me like 10 hours to beat the game once. And then just like, you know, ignore hard, very hard, Dante Must Die, Heaven or Hell, Hell and Hell, like, Legendary Dark Knight. Just ignore all that shit, like, that's not real, it's not actual content. Extra difficulty modes don't mean extra content, streamer, obviously. Are you an idiot? Obviously you're biased because of your speedrunning perspective. Your propensity to replay games as a speedrunner makes you think that having new difficulty modes makes more content for a game. Yeah, but the difficulty modes in RE3 sucked? No, they don't, dude. Nightmare and Inferno are great modes. They're fun. They, like, actually just legit changed the game. I think that people just... I legit had comments on my video saying that they had no idea there was a dodge mechanic in RE3 Remake. And these are the same people saying that is not a good game and it doesn't have any content. It's like, yeah, the game literally doesn't make you use the dodge mechanic on standard or really hardcore, but like on Nightmare and Inferno, there are actual things that make you engage with the mechanics, like the dodge mechanic, you know, like Final Nemi. And therefore, it is substantially different from your other playthroughs. Shit, they even changed key item locations and stuff. How does the dodge mechanic work? When an enemy is about to attack you, you press the dodge button. It's that simple, actually. There's also no mercenaries, which is another disappointment. Okay, but like... bro, none of these people actually played OGRE3, though. This is what I'm saying. Like, people just have like a checklist of stuff that they wanted or that they heard that people wanted, and then just are like, well, this wasn't on the checklist. And so therefore, it's bad. Like, bro, how many people out here that are complaining about no Mercenaries in RE3 Remake, like, have actually played Mercenaries in RE3 Original? Like, zero. I guarantee you it's, like, almost zero. That number is nearing zero on the floating point. But it was an opportunity to improve and add on to it, though, but they didn't want to. It ratioed. They could do whatever they want. Like, okay, this is what I'm saying, though. Like, just because you wanted them to do more with it doesn't mean them deciding to not do more with it makes the game bad. Like, I don't think people understand criticism. Like, yeah, you might be disappointed that the game doesn't have what you want. But I'm also disappointed that my apartment complex doesn't have free cocaine and strippers. But it's not a strip club or a communist party, right? So like, the fact that my apartment complex doesn't have free cocaine and strippers doesn't make it a bad apartment complex. You know what I mean? It makes no fucking sense. Like, there was never a promise of this thing happening. You know what I mean? Like, they never said they were going to do that. Like, that's just your own wishes being portrayed onto the thing. I was supposed to shoot the barrel. Let's try this again. I mean, I don't think it's an objective perspective at all. Like, you don't have to be objective. I don't think there is such a thing as objective criticism. But like, there's a difference between wanting objective criticism and wanting someone to critique something for what it's actually trying to be. Like, you don't have to be some fucking omnipotent, omnipresent being to criticize something, but I would expect you to not criticize Counter-Strike Go for its single-player campaign because it doesn't have one, because it's an esport. You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't make any fucking sense to do that. If you came out with a review of Counter-Strike saying, you know, I really wish that there was a single-player campaign, this game is not good, you know, 0 out of 10, I don't think anyone should take your review seriously in any capacity. Because that just doesn't make any fucking sense. Like, if you do that, you're just stupid.
Oh,
Like, that's just not... I don't know, like... And I don't really think I'm bringing a false equivalence here. It feels pretty accurate to me. I mean, if you think so, then give me a better example of a game like that, Angel Powder. I mean, I'm sure there are some, but there's... I mean, you know, like a short, digestible, highly replayable game with some fun base mechanics with like a dodge and shooting, you know, with a horror aesthetic. I don't know, I think it's great. It's fun. It's a fun game. Not every game needs to be a 30-hour RPG with, you know, 20 hours of unskippable cutscenes and blah, blah, blah. I don't think it's a bad game, just extremely disappointed when they take the name of the character, change everything else completely, and then call it a remake. I mean, that's one thing you could do with a remake. I mean, a remake is literally making the game again. Like, you could do whatever you want with it. You know, it doesn't have to be a certain type of way. Like, a remake doesn't have to be a Blue Point remake where everything is exactly the same. And it's just an upgraded, like, fidelity and, like, remade from the ground up. You know, a remake can be whatever the fuck you want it to be. That's the beauty of a remake. And personally, I don't really see a point in remaking a game one-to-one. Like, it already exists. You know what I mean? Like, it already exists. Like, why is there a need to remake RE3 one-to-one? Just play OG RE3. It still exists. It holds up just fine. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, it's got some low quality textures and models in some places. But like, bro, who fucking cares? Just play the video game. You know what I mean? They don't sell OG RE3 though. I mean, emulate it. It's free. Just steal that shit, dude. Fuck Capcom. Just emulate it or buy it from like a third-party game store. I see OGRE games all the time at like local game shops. They're not even expensive. Now, see, I disagree with that, Angel Powder, because I really don't like RE4 Remake's core mechanics. I feel like... So, literally, there's a story about RE4 OG's development where the director told everybody, look, don't care about the story. We're not even going to write the narrative until, like, the game's almost done. What we're going to do is we're going to focus entirely on the gameplay mechanics and making them as fun and responsive as possible. And that's what they did. They revolutionized the camera. They made some super tight and engaging controls. And then they, you know, just made the story, like, last second around that. And that's, like, the core essence of the original games, the original RE4. And RE4 Remake sacrifices gameplay elements in every single capacity whenever it can to enhance the narrative slash, like, aesthetic. Which is the exact opposite of what the original game does. So I think on a spiritual level... It really kind of betrays the original, which is why I don't like it that much. Like, that's fine. They could do that. Like, that's their plan. That's their prerogative, right? But I think it kind of goes against the spirit of the original, which they don't give a fuck about the spirit of the original. So that's fine. They could do whatever they want with it. But personally, I just really dislike that. That's like people who say they don't want to play a game because it's old, and I have some friends who say that with Resident Evil 4 and Silent Hill. See, okay, but like, here's the thing. This is like the same thing people ask, like, dude, I would love for there to be a Left 4 Dead 3. People say this all the time, and I go, why? And they just can't tell me. They have no idea. They don't, they literally can't, they can't tell me. Because the reason why they want a Left 4 Dead 3 is not because they think the aesthetic should be better, or like they want new and improved gameplay mechanics, or like new content or anything like that, because Left 4 Dead 2 has a timeless aesthetic. It controls better than like any other game ever, because it's a Source game and they always control amazingly. And it has like unlimited content because of the mod workshop, and there's a ton of vanilla content too. The game's really well balanced. It has a ton of engaging mechanics. Literally the reason why people want Left 4 Dead 3 is because they want their friends that refuse to play old games to play it again. They want a reason for the game to be culturally relevant again, so they can give them an excuse to play it. That's why. And I feel like that's why people want remakes of these games too, like RE4, the OG RE games, because they feel like there isn't a cultural significant reason for them to go and play them again. But like, I shit you not, I swear to God, if you just go and play the old games, they're fun. Like, if you have friends that refuse to play old games, find new friends. Like, I don't know what to tell you. Like, if you want to play old games and your friends refuse to play old games, then just find someone new to play with. You know, there are plenty of people who like older games or whatever it is, and like will play them with you. I assure you. And it's like just so annoying. Instead of getting anything actually new, instead of like actually innovating or doing anything new, they're just like trying to convince companies to re-release the same products over and over and over again with slight variations so that they can maintain some social cultural relevancy, which gives people an excuse to engage with it. But I don't know. I hate that mindset, because it's like, okay, if you need there to be a socially cultural relevant reason for you to play a video game, do you really like video games? Like, I'm not sure that you do, because if that's the only reason you're engaging in it, then maybe you just like social interactions, which is fine, but that doesn't necessarily mean that the gaming industry should cater to you because you want social interactions. Like, just find some activity that already exists that gives you those social interactions. You know what I mean? And I guess it's fine for you to want that to be, you know, gaming to be a part of that, because it's part of the interest. But I don't know. Does the whole entire gaming industry need to just like stop and just remake and re-release old games forever because this is like a big thing that people want, like this games to be like culturally relevant again? Like, you could make those games culturally relevant again just by continuing to play them. Like, look at something like Smash or CSGO. Or like one point, like Counter-Strike, you know, like these games still exist in the cultural zeitgeist, and like people still play them because people still play them. Like, if you just play them and make a community around them, then it'll just continue to exist. Like, you don't have to re-relate. Like, CSGO would have lasted for like countless years without a CS2. Personally, in that example, I think that it's only a benefit because Valve is really good with these types of things. But I mean, CSGO in and of itself would have been fine for like a really, really long time. First three DMC games remake would be so great. Hopefully they keep the difficulty and secret mechanics though. I mean, you say that, but you could just play the first three DMC games. I mean, like, two of them are still like phenomenally good games. Like, definitely DMC 1 and DMC 3 are some of the best action games ever made to this day and hold up really well. And like, I guarantee you haven't gotten everything there is to get out of those games. You know what I mean? And there is a community of people that still regularly play those games. So like, why wait for a remake? Just go play it, dude. It's still there. You know what I mean? What about a remake of DMC2? I would prefer that Capcom just stop making video games, because I don't really like anything they made in the last like decade, so. I agree with you, but it'd be cool to see new enemies, areas, and stuff. Then they could make a sequel. Or, I don't know, you could see entirely new enemies and areas if they just make a new game.
Wait.
I don't think people understand that, like, these games that get all these remakes and stuff, like, somebody had to make a new idea in order for these games to be so popular that people want endless remakes of them. So, like, if you never let new games exist, then there will never be new properties that become these games that people want endless remakes of. What about Alternate Universe DMC? Have you thought of that? Yeah, that's called Reboot, and it was in 2013, and it caused many people to send death threats to Ninja Theory.
Wait.
You wouldn't mind a remaster of DMC 1 and 3? Well, boy, do I have a surprise for you. Those already exist. There are already remasters for DMC 1 and 3. It's called the HD Collection that released in 2013. Before RE4 Remake came out, people said that a lot about this game. They're like, yeah, I don't really think it needs a remake, but I'd love an HD remaster for RE4. And I'm like, wow, you mean like the one I'm playing right now? That would be cool. I guess I meant with better graphics, I kept the style of them, but I'm not saying that would be necessary. That's literally what the HD Collection is. Congratulations, you hit the nail on the head. That is exactly what HD Collection is. That's also exactly what this is. I think I might have heard you say you're not a big fan of DMC 5. Mind explaining why? Nope. I do mind explaining why. I'm not going to. I don't feel like it. But okay, so I'm kind of two-faced on this issue, because while I do feel that way about remakes and remasters and all that shit, like, on the flip side, it's great content, so I will gladly play whatever dog shit game that Capcom puts out and make money off of it. For the views. So honestly, like, I'm down like a clown till I'm dead in the ground for them to just, like, keep remaking the same five games forever, and I just keep playing them forever and just, like, make infinite money, to be honest. I'm down. I mean, it hurts my soul a little bit. But, whatever. Fuck it. Yeah, it sounds like a fair trade, Salton. Yeah, I mean, I made like 17 grand or whatever from RE4 Remake coming out. Do I have any intention of ever playing it again? I mean, not in any extreme capacity. Okay, but if you're an OG RE3 fan, you cannot say that the remix gameplay is worse. You just can't, dude. The OG RE games, like, dude, the tank controls and the non-functioning dodge mechanic, like, bro. You can just not say that that gameplay is worse. It's just objectively not. Yeah, it's perfectly balanced, as all things should be. Oh, I wanted that spinel. Oh well.
No!
Leon! Oh. Anyways, now that I have content for the podcast, we can talk about normal stuff again.
Welcome. Got some. What are you selling? Is that all? Thank you. Is that?
That's our code Veronica. Classic RE games suck. I never played it.
Thank you.
Really, the only classic RE game I've actually played is 3. Did you ever realize that RE 4 and 5 use tank controls? Yeah, but they don't have this dog shit fixed camera angle that no one likes, and they don't feel bad to play as compared to the classic games. It's not so much necessarily the tank controls themselves that are bad, it's just that the whole system in place feels really clunky. Have I played Spider-Man on PS4? No. You thought the voice acting in 3 Make wasn't that good? Honestly, I'll agree with you. It's definitely better than 2 Make's voice acting, though. Like, I'm legit like, dude, is Claire okay? Like, did she hit her head before she recorded these lines? Like, what is happening? I think people want to experience the same thing again for the very first time, which is literally impossible. I agree. People do. Nostalgia is a hell of a drug, but this is not going to happen. OG RE4 has terrible movement, but it's so easy to control that it becomes better than the one in the remakes. Well, see, yeah, like RE4 OG is definitely unwieldy, but it gives you a lot of control. Like, it's hard to control, but you can control everything. Unlike RE4 Remake, where it's easy to control, but you can't have precise control. So you feel like you're fucking walking around drunk out of your mind when you're playing that game. Like, you just want to turn around and Leon has to do a fucking NASCAR left turn, or takes like 10 seconds. But you could just do both, like, I don't know, it's not that hard. Have I played Metal Gear Solid? No, because I like video games, and every time someone mentions Metal Gear Solid, they always mention how good the cutscenes are. So I just kind of avoid it. Because I prefer video games over movies. At least in my video games. Would you continue speedrunning RE4 as mercenary characters, Ada, Hank, and Leon? His name is Hunk, but you would like to see Leon? I am currently speedrunning as the mercenary character, Leon, as we speak. I know what you mean, though, like, with his loadout and stuff. Honestly, that sounds awful. But maybe. What's up, Sickle? I don't know how... I mean, I did Hunk runs. I just never turned it into a video. Which reminds me, I should probably turn that into a video. I did do Hunk runs, though. And I never did Ada. I don't know how I would make... Like, how would I even market doing it as Leon? I have no idea. What would a RE4 speedrun look like if you were playing as Leon? Wait a second. Put a Soko model over it. I wish I could in OG4. But that doesn't exist in this port of RE4, I believe. Like, model swaps. For, like, there's no way to import models, I believe. You could do model swaps, obviously, but not, like, from external models. I don't think the tools exist for that. Boom, bitch. Doesn't DMC have a fixed camera? The first DMC game has some fixed cameras, and so does DMC 2. Well, DMC1 is entirely fixed cameras. But those camera angles are pretty good. For the most part. There's a couple bad ones, but I'd say like 85% to 90% of them are pretty solid. DMC3 has some fixed cameras, but you also have like direct camera control in a lot of rooms. 4 and 5 have like fully controllable cameras in every room. Nah, I never run Lucia. Just Dante. How do you get mercenaries characters in the main game? It's a mod. Mod's on my Patreon. If you want it. Well, this is set up for the mod. It's also on Nexus. But the setup video and stuff is there. No, I haven't Momotif not yet. I genuinely don't know how we've gone so far backwards with movement video games, though. Like, sure, like, early movement sucked, you know, like 3D movement at least, like tank control, RE games and stuff, that shit's awful, but almost equally as awful is like the new, like, you're super weighty in all your animations and there's like a bunch of input lag type shit like RE4 Remake. IMO, that's like almost equally as awful. Like, how do we get away from like DMC1 and DMC3's movement? Like, that it's so good. It's just like, that's just like vanilla. That's like default. That's like what all games should have. It's like that. you know, it's like a complete shock to me that anyone would make anything else besides like that. Like, just hyper responsive, works perfectly fine, like, looks great. How do I feel about Dead Space Remake's movement? It's great. It's just, it's deep, it's just movement, it's just correct. That's so unlucky. You body blocked the whole thing. Because the gaming industry started getting more and more mainstream, you're right, it's time to gatekeep. Gatekeep, girl boss. I love when I shoot enemies and they don't stun. There is some truth to that though. I started catering to more like mainstream audiences. They sacrifice gameplay for aesthetic a lot more. Yeah, Dead Space doesn't have tank controls. You always move, like, forward. That makes sense. Like, you're always moving. Like, if you hold right, you move to the right. You know? It's always dependent on your camera. I don't know what you're talking about. I love it when games feel heavy and sluggish in their movement. Honestly, based. Based modern game enjoyer. I respect it. You play that dead of night? It's terrifying. No, I don't like horror games. I just want to blow shit up, dude. Why do you think DMC3 is my favorite game? Because you can use a crazy fucking bat scythe guitar to combo enemies and juggle them around the map while riding on top of a rocket, spinning around in circles and shouting woohoo. That shit is sick. That's what I like about video games. I don't know though. Yeah, but it's not necessarily true. Like, I think Valve is probably my favorite company now. It used to be Capcom, but now it's definitely Valve, because like when I look at CS2's beta, I see exactly like they understand what makes Counter-Strike a great video game and are like just making it even better. Like, they're doing literally exactly what I like about video games. They're like, just make it look pretty, just like, just make it look pretty and make the gameplay as solid and flawless as possible. Like, they're just like, okay, how does this affect gameplay? Like, what are all the little gameplay things we can fix? Like, how do we adjust these guns to make them slightly more balanced? And like, it's fucking phenomenal. Like, the other day they put out this huge update where they're like, okay, we heard what you guys were saying about like advanced movement and bunny hopping and stuff, and we fixed it. Like, we changed the entire movement system to like adjust for these really niche things. Like, they made it so that bunny hopping worked like the way it used to in CSGO when you're using console commands that don't even work in competitive play. Like console commands that are turned off by default. They're like adjusting the way the systems work so that when the console commands that are turned off by default are on, things work the way that they're supposed to. Like, they did in CSGO. First, like, stuff that, you know, 2% of the entire player base is gonna care about. Like, just getting the movement, like, perfect. Like, what other game company is gonna fucking do that? Literally none. No other game company will ever do anything like that. They're like, what's that? Like, skill-based movement in our game? That sounds cringe. That makes it, you know, less... the wider audience isn't gonna care about that, so just scrap it. Fuck it. You know what I mean? But they put out, like, a whole Twitter thread about, like, all the changes that they made for, like, this super niche, nuanced stuff about movement.
What are you buying?
And, like, that is shit that only someone like Valve would do. Which is why they're probably my favorite devs now. For sure. Because you know what happens when you do... When you, like, inform people at a high level in game companies about stuff like that for other games? Because I can tell you exactly what happens when you tell Capcom about that type of stuff. You go, hey, Capcom... They used to have these things called reversals in DMC5 during the demo. They add like a ton of skill ceiling to the game and make it way more fun to play. Why did you get rid of them? Oh, yeah, we didn't really even know those existed. Honestly, a couple people did it on accident, so we just removed them. Like, I assure you not, that's the response. But, you know, when you say something like that to Valve, they're like, oh, that's, we're sorry, like, how can we fix this? Like, what's the sort of middle ground we can reach or something? You know, let's put a ton of fucking dev time and work into making it exactly right so that it benefits, like, every level of play. B-Hop works in CS2? Yeah. Pretty sick. Yeah, they posted a whole Twitter thing about it. It might not be official out yet. I think it is though. But they definitely like posted some shit about it on Twitter. Yeah, Valve is based. Based Valve. Well, I mean, they're kind of right, though, Raiden. Like, no one... Like, if you think about it in the grand scheme, no one cares. Like, does removing the laser sight from RE4 Remake and adding Bloom to the gun make the game worse? Yes. But does anyone actually care? Like, will that reduce sales? No. So, like, if they want to do it, they're just going to do it. No one's going to care. You know what I mean? Yeah, I mean, there are a lot of people that say that Bloom sucks and they're not a fan of it, but... The percentage of those people that are actually like a part of the overall percentage of people that have played the game at all is like 1%, maybe. Probably not even 1%. So like, does it actually affect Capcom in any meaningful way? Not really. You know, they can just be like, fuck you. We're not changing it. We're not doing anything about it. Yeah, I know some people care, but you still bought the game, so in their eyes, you don't care. Right? Like, it doesn't matter. It might make you like the game like 10% less, but you still bought it. Like, it literally doesn't matter. Like, if you... This will put a lot of perspective for you on how game sales actually work. if you look at the achievement trackers for games, like you look at the achievement tracker for RE7 and it's like, you know, something crazy like 30% of people who bought the game have never played it at all, like haven't even launched it. And, you know, 50% of people have never beaten the game. So, but all those people bought the game. And Capcom makes money when you buy the game, not when you play it. So, there really is no, like, as long as they get you to buy the game, and as long as it's not such a big thing that you refuse to buy games from them in the future, then it doesn't matter, basically. It's a non-factor. Because why should they cater to someone who is going to play their game a lot when, you know, 30% of their audience doesn't even open the game?
Wait, follow me.
And 50% never even beats it one time. The issues that people come up from that, you know, stem from the people that play the game the most are the ones that matter the least. Those changes like Bloom and stuff are the reason why RE4R won't get displayed as much in the next few years. Maybe. I think that that's gonna stop it from being like the classic, the GOAT, you know, like OG RE4 is. But OG RE4 already exists. So this is what's gonna happen. They have absolved themselves of that problem because people will go, man, I hear RE4 is like this GOAT of a game. I wanna play it. And some people are gonna be like, you know, the better experience overall is just to play the remake. So they'll just play the remake instead. Because it is true that for most players, the better casual experience will be to play the remake. So, you know, it's... The remake was never meant to be like this GOAT game that like replaces the original legacy. It's just like a slight update that they can get people to buy when they want that feeling of playing the original. Like, RE4 Remake will never be the insane behemoth that the original was, but it doesn't have to be. It just has to be a stepping stone for people that haven't played the original or have played the original and want to replay it, but don't want to deal with, like, you know, sourcing and finding, like, the old version or getting it to work or whatever. He said, are you from New York or something? That's funny. Well, it's more true for the OG games, like... I think that's part of the reason why they don't release the OG games anywhere. Because they're like, well, they're classics, so people want to play them for like the lineage and the history alone. And so we can make the remakes and then just have people buy the remakes instead. And then you have the kind of this intermediary that... Well, you can't really get the OGs, so I guess I'll play the remake. You think the remake is better for this game? I could see it. I genuinely believe that the remake is a better experience for like majority of players. It's a solid game. I just don't like it as much because it doesn't feel as good to play mechanically. My opinion, Blue Minority 2 Remake is alright since it incentivizes you to wait for a small reticle to save ammo. I guess. But like... I don't know. If you're shooting stuff in RE2 Remake, you're playing it wrong in my opinion. You should not shoot- you should never shoot a gun in that game. Unless you're fighting a boss. Like, there's just no point. Regular zombies take 12,000 years to kill and they're super easy to avoid, so like, why bother killing them? A minute. If you're a vector. RE3 Remake better than RE2 Remake? Based in correct opinion. Correct opinion haver in chat. Love the Clock Tower in RE3 Remake. It's better than the Clock Tower in RE3 OG. RE1 Remake the best? I don't know. I think certain games should be removed from the title of video game and just be video. Because there isn't really much game there. You know? Like, RE7 is definitely a video.
Been a long time, comrade.
Krauser. A diner crash 2 years ago. Is that what they told you? You're the one who kidnapped Ashley. You catch on quick, as expected. After all, you and I both know where we come from. What do you want? The sample Sadler developed, that's all. Leave Ashley out of this. Oh, I needed her to buy Sadler's trust in me. Like you, I'm American. Barrel. You got her involved just for that? Ha! Ting! Ting, ting. Ting, ting. All for Umbrella's sake.
Umbrella?
Almost let it slip. Enough talk. Die, comrade. When's RE7 going to be on the Patreon polls? Well, it's only games I actually speedrun. And besides, I don't think that Capcom would take very kindly to me playing their entire movie on my stream. I think I'd get like a DMCA claim or something.
You may be able to prolong your life, but it's not like you can escape your inevitable death, is it?
It's funny, RE4 Remake is good, a good game overall, well done, but it's a remake of a game he contributed a lot to video games as a whole, and RE4 Remake is the most standard experience you could get in 2023. Dude, honestly, that's based. That's a based take. I'm not a big streamer, I can't get away with playing whole movies on stream, you know? I'm not like Pokemon or something. I can't just like watch Lord of the Rings on stream. Or RE7. Not Pokemon. Somebody did. I remember that though. I think I might have been XQC. Twitch streamers be wild though. People just be watching movies on stream. Honestly, RE4 Remake's best game 2023 by far? Maybe. I think the best game of 2023 is DMC3 though, to be honest. My favorite game of 2023? Definitely DMC3. It's my favorite game every year, though. Honestly, I shat on it, but Tripping 2 actually looks pretty good. DMC3 wins Game of the Year once again for the 23rd year in a row. Or no, it would be, how many years? Came out in, 05, right? So it'd be 18 years in a row. Personally, I thought Dead Space Remake was a more solid experience overall than RE4 Remake. But they were both really good. I definitely thought Dead Space Remake was a better remake, if that makes sense. Like, genuinely, I see no reason to play the original Dead Space anymore. Like, it has been successfully just removed, you know? Dead Space Remake is just better in every way. Gollum was the best game of the year. Oh, true. I forgot about Gollum. My bad. But yeah, I mean, genuinely, like, I as a big fan of Dead Space, I don't see a reason to ever play Dead Space 1 again. I just play Remake. It's just better. Did RE2 Remake achieve the same thing? Is there any reason to play the original? There's definitely a reason to play the original. There's like a ton of nuances and cool shit between like the A and B scenarios that just doesn't exist in the Remake. That is like definitely the coolest part of OG RE2. I think that alone is a good enough reason to play OG RE2.
What are you buying? What are you selling? What are you buying? Thank you.
But that's just one of your PC's ass. I don't know, it doesn't run very well on PC, so a remake might actually run better. Sure, we can all agree that RE4 Remake is better than 99% of modern popular games. True, but modern popular games suck. That bar's kind of low. I play Castillo? I don't play movies. My inventory is tighter than Ashley's pants. I cannot fit anything in here. Bruh. Well, that's the remake experience, Silver. Like, who cares about like whether it's going to be fun to play multiple times, because 30% of people that bought the game don't even play it once, and only 50% ever actually beat the game once. So why would you bother designing the game / bosses / mechanics to actually be fun and replayable and not just an initial spectacle when no one actually plays the game all the way through or, you know, replays it? That's like the fundamental flaw with modern game design, in my opinion. Because, like, well, it's not really a flaw. I mean, it works, right? Like, for them, it works. For the game companies, it works. For most people, it works. But for people like us that like to play the games a lot and again and again and again and want them to, like, stand the test of time, it doesn't work. Because it's all just spectacle, like a one-time enjoyment thing. But yeah, on replays, it really drags.
Prepare for your death, Leon.
Yeah, thanks for going around. That's just the reality of the industry, I guess. Which is why I have decided that I am just going to play old games and not care about new games, unless it's a direct sequel or remake of something that I've already played, and then I'm going to farm it for content, and then I'm going to go back to playing the games that I know are good. Like, I have like 10 games or whatever that I really like, maybe like 15, that are really, really good and I could just play forever. And I'm just going to play those games forever. And I'm not going to try anything new. And if one of those games gets like a remake or a remaster or like a sequel, then I'll try it. but I'm not invested because I know that I could just continue to play those original games and it'll be fine. No, I don't have any interest in Elden Ring. It's all... Wasn't really a fan. I liked it casually, but the more I played it, the more I disliked it. Another Doom game? I mean, Doom Eternal is already basically a perfect game. I legit can't think of a single thing that would make Doom Eternal better, except for just fixing some bugs. But I'll never do that, so... But like, it has a ton of content. The campaign's really long and engaging. The master levels are super fun. There's two like real full-ass game-length DLCs. The mechanics are phenomenal. They're super tight and engaging and fun. It's a near flawless game. I see no reason for there to be a sequel. I hate shield guys. Should've just ran. I beat the game on Ultra Nightmare. No, but I've never really tried. I beat it on Nightmare a bunch. I did a bunch of Nightmare 100% runs. What's up, killer? Yeah, but they could have, like, you know, just removed Island entirety and made the game even better than it is. And for make IMO. Damn. Capital of Canada, where they make all the maple syrup? How was that? Yeah, it's salted. I was gonna do Ultra Nightmare 100%, but I never got around to it. I did a bunch of Nightmare 100% runs though. What even is the capital of Canada? I don't know. Yeah, Yeah, Ultra Nightmare and Nightmare are the exact same thing. It's just Ultra Nightmare has permadeath. Ottawa? Let's see. Yeah, Muichiro. Sure. I don't see why not. Bum 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 bum. I gotta poop.
Hang on, sweetheart.
.42-20, not bad.
Here we go.